you see the thing is called the Lord. Thank you, praise the Lord for all that the Lord is doing. Thank God for what our eyes have seen thus far, our ears have heard. Thank God for every testimony that was given, every song of praise that was written before our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, every scripture that was quoted for the edification of our brother and sister. And truly, it's good for us to be here.
Amen.
Thank God.
Amen.
His goodness and His mercy is extended toward us, the children of men. Amen. But most of all, I thank God for one day having the honor to repent of my sins, to go down in the water in the name of Jesus Christ. The Lord did fill my soul with the precious gift of God.
Hallelujah.
And that with a mighty burning fire.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank God for the way of holiness.
Thank you, Jesus.
I'm striving in this way every day.
Thank you, Lord.
To make heaven my home. Amen. How y'all feel tonight?
Hallelujah. Good.
You feel all right?
Yes, sir.
Thank God for seeing you tonight.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank God for you.
I'm in the house of the Lord.
Yes, sir.
It's good to see you all on this side.
Likewise.
As we always say, could have been the other way.
Yes.
I could have been looking at you, you not looking at me.
Right.
You looking at me and I not looking at you.
My Lord.
But it's good to lay eyes on one another in the land of the living.
Yes.
Amen. To embrace one another while we still have a chance. Is that right?
Amen.
Amen. We thank and praise God. We thank and praise God to see all those assembled here tonight. Good to see Sister Willis.
Yes.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. In Jesus' name. Good to see all y'all.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. Brother Darius, it's good to see you out in the house of the Lord again. Amen. Thank God. Amen. We thank God for the wonderful, wonderful time we had in New Jersey. Yes.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Praise God for what
still rejoice.
Amen. And we give Him all the honor.
Yes,
the
He deserves it.
Amen. We took it back to Bible days.
Oh, yes.
The Bible said it went from house to house.
Yes.
And then it was a wonderful experience.
Right. Those,
never experienced it before. It was a wonderful experience.
Amen.
And just being in the house, amen. And worshiping the same God that we worship while in the building.
That's right.
Amen. The same God. We thank God for just the moving of His Spirit. Amen. It's how the Lord did definitely show up.
Yes, He did.
Amen. The spirit of worship was in that place.
Yes, it was.
Amen. You could just feel the presence of God.
Amen.
That's where I want to be, with the presence of the Lord.
That's
is.
Right. Me too.
When the presence of the Lord is, there's fullness of joy.
Yes. Yes.
Amen. And I thank and praise God just for the presence of the Almighty, that you can just feel God.
Yep.
Amen. It's wonderful to feel God.
Yes.
Just thank God for the wonderful testimonies that are even pouring in. Amen. From our being there.
Yes.
There's individuals that have been reaching out. I spoke with Brother Leeks earlier, and the brother said that brother and people been calling him all day long. folks that weren't even there.
Thank you, Jesus.
And so they've been talking about the wonderful time that we had in the Lord.
Glory to God.
And I just thank God for the Lord is doing. And I just thank God for the souls that are turning to the Lord.
Yes, yes.
Thank God. And what the Lord is doing, even one of our own, amen, Sister Joyce, and I thank God for her being
able
to travel and not having to come all the way this way.
Yeah.
Being just a little closer to home.
Yeah.
That's right.
Amen. And I thank and praise God. But I want to say truly, the atmosphere was wonderful.
Yes.
I got to text our sister back. I did get her message, and I haven't been able to text her back yet. But by the grace of God, I'll text her later on this evening or in the morning, but that sister wrote me, amen, a long message today.
Thank you, Jesus.
That service, and her spirit was on fire.
Thank you, Lord.
Feel it from the text message.
Thank you, Lord. Glory, glory. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, sir. Amen.
You're so thankful.
Yes.
Thankful to God for.
Yes.
What she experienced in that service and just being among the saints of God.
Yeah.
And she said she just was glad to see genuine people love the Lord and so love God. And she just said how she felt the presence and the power of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
That was a wonderful thing.
Yes.
And that's why we do what we do.
That's right.
That's
amen.
Why we do what we do. Knowing that people's spirits can be lifted, can be liberated by the power of God.
That's right.
Amen. So that was a wonderful and awesome testimony. I thank God for what the Lord is even doing down on that end. I mean, the brothers, as They're excited about the work of the Lord that is going to take place in that area. And they're working, and we're getting ready to gather together now. And then we may continue on down there and set things in order. Amen. The saints of God can carry on and be in care, as Jesus' name. And it's our desire that we're going to work on the schedule. They're going to come up here one Sunday out of the month. We're going to go down there one Sunday out of the month.
Amen.
In order that we can stay connected and be unified.
Amen.
As a body. In Jesus' name. And we're just going to encourage them as much as we can for the work that is at hand there. Amen. And even though we're starting the work there among the brethren, you know, one man can't run everything.
No.
And I thank God the Lord has given me wisdom, knowledge, and understanding in His Word. And He called 12 apostles. And
that's right. Amen.
Amen.
So, amen.
I'm not even going to try to burden myself.
That's
down.
Right. Amen.
Being at two places at one time. Mm-hmm. I'm not a spirit. I can't do it. Amen. But God has raised up capable brothers, and He's raising up capable brothers.
Thank you, Lord.
And that are able to carry the work on. Yes. Thank God for what He's doing. Paul told Timothy, he said, commit these things to faithful men that will be able to teach others also. Yes, amen. And we're going to do it just like the Bible said.
Amen.
Amen. We're going to raise up and teach faithful men that can teach others also.
Yes,
amen. So I give God the honor and the praise for the work, amen, that started there, and I see that location flourishing.
Yes.
Amen.
The zeal and the fire.
Yes, yes.
And just the presence of the Lord and the atmosphere there. I can see mighty things happening down there.
Thank you, Lord.
And we thank God, and we're just looking for what the Lord is doing. And then we give Him glory, honor, and praise. And we thank God for all that He's doing. And I mean, I'm so excited. There's so much that I can say. But we'll be here all night long.
Yes, Lord.
I ain't going to keep y'all in here all night long. But the Lord is good.
Yes, He is.
That's what I'm going to say. The Lord is
good. Yes, He is.
And we thank God for what He's doing. For this is the Lord's doing. And it's marvelous in our eyes. Amen. We thank God even for our sister Katrina that traveled down with
us. Amen.
Amen. Amen. She had a wonderful time in the Lord. Yes. And just awesome. You know, the Bible says how good and pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity.
Yes.
It's a wonderful thing when people come together with one mind, one purpose, and magnifying God.
Yeah.
That's how God will show up.
Yes, yes.
Save folks when people are unified.
Amen.
By the power of God. So we're looking for mighty good things for the Lord to do, not only here, but also in our other location that will be in the south of us in New Jersey, Pennsylvania area, whatever the Lord will see fit for us to settle down at. We're looking for great and wonderful things to transpire. Amen. I'm going to call your attention to a few scriptures, and we'll get these out of the way and carry your heart and mind by the help of the Lord.
Yes.
And we're going to get on out of the way. I thank God for all those that accompanied us down. Amen. To New Jersey. I mean, it was beautiful.
Beautiful.
And I'm going to say this. Don't let nobody hinder you.
Amen.
Amen.
Nothing hinder you.
Amen.
Amen. From receiving your blessing.
That's right.
From the Lord.
Amen.
It's good for us to try to make every event that we can.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
We just don't know what God is going to do.
That's right.
Is that right?
That's right. You don't know what He's going to do.
And that might be the opportunity for you to receive your blessing.
Yes.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
I'm just saying this, but I believe not many days hence. And not only do I believe, I know. Now, many days hence, that sister Joyce will receive the Holy Ghost right down there.
Amen. Amen. I want to witness it too.
Right down there.
Amen.
Amen.
Sometimes you got to be removed from the normal.
That's right.
Atmosphere.
In order
for God to get your attention.
Amen.
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 Sometimes things are clouding our vision.
Yeah.
Sometimes things are
distractions. That's
sometimes
right.
We got to be rooted up and moved out.
So many distractions.
Not many days hence.
Nope.
Amen. That sister will receive the precious gift of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Whether I'm present or not.
That's right.
Waiting for the call.
Yes.
That's right.
Amen. To hear her speaking in an unknown tongue.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
God.
Me too.
And I trust God.
Amen.
And I know God is going to do it. Amen. Let's go to 2 Thessalonians, the third chapter.
Amen.
13th verse. I feel good tonight.
Hallelujah.
And God is good.
Yes, He is.
Amen. 2 Thessalonians, the third chapter. Amen. And the 13th verse.
But ye brethren,
And I want to encourage your heart and your mind with the same words that the Apostle Paul encouraged the church that was at Thessalonica. He writes to the church there, and he says what?
But ye brethren.
He said, but ye brethren.
Be not weary.
Be not weary.
In well doing.
In well doing.
Mm-hmm.
And if any man obey not our word by this epistle.
And if any man obey not our word by this epistle.
Note that man.
Have no company with him.
That he may be ashamed.
Mm-hmm.
Yet count him not as an enemy.
Don't count him as an enemy.
But admonish him as a brother.
Mm-hmm. Sometimes you got to withdraw yourself from certain people.
Amen.
In order that you may continue in the work of God.
Mm-hmm.
And the Apostle Paul gives them instruction. He said, brethren, be not weary. In well doing. Amen. The fact of the matter is, sometimes you get weary.
Yes, yes.
And sometimes it seems like you're serving the Lord and you're sacrificing, you're doing this and you're doing that. And it seems like sometimes the cares of the world and burdens begin to weigh you down. Amen. But Paul encourages the saints of God, be not weary.
Thank you, Lord.
In well doing.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. I want to encourage the saints.
Yeah.
God has not forgotten.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Sometimes it seems like we're doing so much, and while we're doing it, we're striving to serve the Lord, and then we look at the Lord and say, well, Lord, have you forgotten about me?
Amen.
When is my change going to come? When is the blessing going to overtake me? Amen. Sometimes we get weary. Amen. Even as Brother Monty stated in his testimony, looking for one job after the next job, going on interview after interview. Seemed like nothing was working.
Mm-hmm.
All of a sudden, God in his timing stepped right in and blessed the brother.
Yeah.
That's what happens
when you don't get weary in well doing.
Amen. Amen.
Sometimes it seems like it's taking long to get to where you're trying to get to. Amen. But if you just hold on and hold out, if you just hold on to God and wait just a little while, God will show up right in the nick of time.
Yeah.
Is that all right?
Amen.
But you just got to continue on.
Yes.
Be not weary in well doing.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Give me Acts the 10th chapter, first person. I'm going to show y'all a brother that waited on the Lord.
Thank you.
Trusted in God.
Thank you, Jesus.
He did everything that he could do. And God remember him.
Thank you, Lord.
Is that right?
Amen.
Amen. Acts the 10th chapter, the first verse. The word said what, brother?
There was a certain man in Caesarea. Called Cornelius.
Mm-hmm.
A centurion. Of the band called. The Italian man. He was a devout man. And one that feared God.
With all his house.
Which gave much alms to the people.
And prayed to God always.
Mm-hmm. Verse 3.
Yes, sir.
He saw in a vision. Evidently about the ninth hour. An angel of God. Coming unto him. And saying unto him.
Cornelius.
And when he looked on him.
He was afraid.
And said.
What is it, Lord?
And the angel said unto Cornelius. Thy prayers.
And thy alms.
Come up. For a memorial before God.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Isn't it good to know that whatever you're doing, God is watching?
Yes.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
The Bible says Cornelius prayed always, gave much alms to the people.
Yes.
He was a devout man that feared God.
Amen.
But Cornelius was missing something.
Mm.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Yeah.
Cornelius was missing the true plan of salvation.
Yeah.
Mm.
He only knew God to a certain level.
Amen.
Only was familiarized with God to a certain extent.
Mm-hmm.
But that brother devoted himself.
Yes, he did.
Prayed always. Kept giving money to the poor.
Yeah.
Did everything that he knew to do.
Yes.
And one day, in a vision, the angel of the Lord comes there and says, Cornelius, thy prayers and thy arms have came up as a memorial
my
to God.
Lord, thank
what
you, Lord.
Memorial are you building today?
Yes. My Lord.
Amen.
Good
Amen.
Question.
Sometimes you just got to go through.
Yes.
Sometimes you got to do what is right to do, even when the odds seem like they're stacked against you.
Yes. Yes.
Seem like folk turning away from you.
Yes. Amen.
Nothing's going the way that you want it to go.
Yes.
Nothing is working out. But if you just hang on in there.
Just hang on.
Keep trusting in God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Keep serving God.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
Keep giving. Keep yes. praying.
Yeah.
One day those yes. things are going to come up to God as a memorial.
Yes. Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Amen. I'm glad we serve a God that sees everything.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Amen. We serve a God that does not have amnesia. Praise the name of the Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
God don't have Alzheimer's.
Uh-huh.
He don't forget nothing.
That's right.
Praise the name of our God.
Remember it
God
all.
God keeps a record of everything that we're doing.
That's right.
That's what everything. Paul told the church. Be not weary and well doing.
Well doing.
Amen. Sometimes it seems like nobody's recognizing you. And everybody's overlooking you. And nobody's paying attention to what you're doing. As long as God remembers, I'm satisfied.
That's right.
Amen. If God remembers what I'm doing, I'm satisfied with it.
Hey. Thank you,
God
Jesus.
God is a good rewarder
yes,
to
yes.
them that diligently seek
him.
Yes. Amen. And see, sometimes God will be silent on purpose.
Yeah.
Yes. See, if you
see
will
what
stand.
You're going to do. That's right.
See, sometimes we think that God's not there. God's not listening. Sometimes we do it.
Uh-huh.
Now, let's be real.
That's the truth. That's the truth.
Sometimes get to the place. God, do you hear me?
Yeah.
Lord, do you see what I'm doing?
Boy, do you see
I'm
this?
I'm trying to serve you. I'm laboring. I'm working. I'm fasting. I'm praying. I'm being faithful. I'm singing. I'm giving. I'm doing all this stuff. But Lord, do you see what I'm doing? Sometimes we get like that.
Yes.
And humanity starts kicking in. God don't see me. God don't hear me. God's not paying attention. Yeah. But right when you least expect it, God will send you a reminder that I see and I hear and I'm watching. Hang on in there.
That's right. Thank you, Lord.
I love the way God will work.
Yeah.
God will do it in a subtle and small way.
Yeah.
Sometimes we're looking for God to come in a big bang and a big boom. Sometimes we're looking for God in the big thing.
Yes.
You know,
yes.
Elijah was in the cave, and the Bible said a wind came and rent the mountain, but God was not in the wind. Then comes a fire. God was not in the fire. And then an earthquake started coming, shaking the mountain, but God wasn't in the earthquake.
No, no.
Everything that you would think God was in, he wasn't in.
That's right.
All of a sudden, hey. A still small voice.
Yes, Lord.
And God was in that still small voice.
Oh, boy.
Praise the name of our God.
Hey,
sometimes
man.
It's the small things that God's in
that's
and
right.
we're overlooking.
That's right. Amen.
Amen.
Sometimes
Amen.
We're looking for God to shake up some stuff. Yeah. We're looking for things to get hot and bothered. And the stuff that we're looking for God in, God is nowhere in.
Amen.
Yeah. Here comes God in a small, subtle way to remind you that I'm looking, I'm listening, I'm watching, I'm hearing your prayer.
Yeah. Yeah.
Praise the name of the Lord. But you can't get weary in well doing.
Amen.
Amen. You got to have the understanding that God sees me. And no matter how long I got to wait, I'm going to wait on
Amen.
God.
Amen.
Amen. I'm going to trust in God. I'm going to serve God. Job was in a predicament for a long time. Job didn't know how he was getting out.
That's right.
But Job made up in his mind. He said, though he slay me, yet will I trust him.
Yeah.
And he said, all my appointed things, I'm going to wait until my change comes. Sometimes.
That's right.
Amen.
Got to wait.
Amen. He didn't tell us how long we had to wait.
No.
He just said, wait.
Yes.
Wait on the Lord and be of good courage.
That's right.
And he will strengthen thy heart. Sometimes the wait on God.
Yeah. Amen.
Everything ain't going to happen overnight.
No.
It ain't going to happen instantaneously. Sometimes you just have to wait on God.
Amen.
And in your waiting, you got to work while you're waiting.
You got to work.
What do you work with the Lord said? He said, occupy until I come.
Amen.
The word occupy means work.
Work.
You got to do something.
Got to.
While you're waiting on the Lord.
That's right.
Amen. You're looking for God to deliver. You're looking for God to save. You're looking for God to heal. You're looking for God to make ways out of your way. And while you're waiting, you got to praise Him while you're waiting.
Yes. Amen.
Worship Him while you're waiting. Be thankful while you're waiting.
Amen.
And when you do all that you know to do, you do some more.
That's right.
In the name of the Lord. You just keep adding to it. You just keep going. And after a while, God won't show you. I've seen you the whole time.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Amen. And sometimes God will wait. He waits until you get to the place where you feel like giving up.
Yeah. Amen.
I love the way God does stuff. Sometimes God waits till you get down on your last dime. Sometimes God waits until you got just a little bit of strength left. And in the minute you were about to give up and throw in the towel, here comes God renewing the strength.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you,
God,
Jesus.
Waits till you get almost to the breaking point. And then God will step in and show you, I'll never leave you. Neither will I forsake you. Praise the name of our God.
Yes,
but sometimes you just got to wait. Amen. And in your waiting, in your patience, possess ye your soul. Amen. Sometimes you just have to wait. Bible said, let patience have her perfect work, that you may be perfect and entire, wanting nothing. Amen. Sometimes God will just make you go through. Amen. God will just make you suffer that thing long. That's what long suffering means. You got to suffer for a long time. Amen. Sometimes God will make you suffer long. Amen. Just see how faithful you're going to be.
That's right.
How diligent you're going to be. Are you going to buckle, turn, throw in the towel, backslide? What you going to do in your waiting? Praise the name of our God. What you going to do while you're suffering for a long time? Amen. Are you still going to be faithful? Amen. When your bank account looking funny, are you still going to come and put whatever you can in the offering? Amen. You see your brother and sister in need, are you still going to help your brother and sister?
Right. Amen.
Sometimes we start going through stuff, and I'm going through, woe is me.
Right.
And then we don't want to come to church. Right. Don't want to help nobody.
Amen.
See somebody in need and you thinking, well, you know, it ain't enough for me and you. Praise the name of God. It ain't enough for me and you. So therefore, since it ain't enough for me and you, I'm going to hold on to it for myself. But you know, God is looking for that individual that will prefer somebody over them and say, I know this is my last, but I'm going to give it to my brother and sister anyway.
Amen.
Praise the name of our God. He wants to see what you're going to do while you're waiting.
While you're waiting.
Amen. And you got to occupy till he comes.
Yeah.
Sometimes you got to give of your last.
That's the truth.
Don't got enough, but you got to give it anyway.
Amen.
And when you give it, you'll find out that God will remember it.
Yes.
Y'all know that widow woman, all she had was two mites. Praise the name of the Lord. And that Pharisee had a whole bunch of money, and he gave out of his necessity. He gave out of the increase that he had. He threw that money in there knowing that this ain't going to do nothing to my pocket. Because when I walk away from here, I'm still going to have a boatload of money that I'm sitting on. So he tossed the money in. Praise the name of our God. But here comes this widow woman that don't got nothing but these two mites. And she threw both of them in there. And the Lord looked and said, who walked away more justified? Who going to be blessed out of these two individuals? See, it's easy to give and to do and to serve God when everything working in your favor.
Yeah, that's the truth.
Oh, but God wants to see when everything starts getting rocky.
Yes.
When hell is breaking loose in it. When it looks like you don't have nothing coming in, are you still going to be able to be faithful?
Amen.
Amen. Are you still going to be able to give and serve the Lord and still go? See, sometimes we look at things and say, I ain't going because money looking funny. Praise the name of the Lord. Well, I ain't going to do that. But you find out, brothers and sisters, that if you be diligent, in the moment that you sacrifice something and to do something, you get there and God will bless you.
Yes, he will.
Amen. Because he looks at your diligence. He looks at how you still serve him when all odds are stacked against you.
Yes. Yes.
See, God's not looking for that one that's doing it because they got it to do it. Right. God's looking at that one that don't got it to do it, but got a mind that I still want to serve the Lord regardless.
That's right.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Yes, Lord.
That's who gets blessed, not the one that's throwing it out there because they can do it. Amen. The true testimony of a believer is when they're going through hardship.
Amen.
Amen.
When they're going through trouble and they're still able to serve the Lord.
Yes.
Paul said, brethren, be not weary in well doing.
Yes.
Amen. Sometimes you just have to wait on the Lord.
Yes.
Amen. Cornelius did all that he could. And the Bible said, thy prayers and thy alms have come up for a memorial before God.
Amen.
It's a good thing for God to remember you.
Yes.
But you've got to give God something to remember.
That's right. Amen.
You've got to give God something to remember.
Amen.
Amen. You got to stick out. See, you if everybody in the crowd is doing the same thing, and nobody's sticking out like a sore thumb, you don't remember people.
That's true.
Amen.
See, if everybody looking the same way, you know, you don't remember people. But see, y'all remember that little game that we had, Where's Waldo?
Yes.
And see, everybody in the crowd would be looking the same, but Waldo was just a little different. Mm-hmm. And you had to look real closely to spot him out of the crowd.
Mm-hmm.
After a while, after looking, you finally said, there's Waldo. God's doing the same thing to us.
Yes.
He's looking for that individual that will stick out in the crowd.
Yes.
He's looking for somebody to remember.
Wow.
But you got to give God something to remember.
Yes,
amen. You can't start going through testing, storms, and trials and tribulation, and then do like everybody else doing, looking all sad.
Yeah.
Walking around moping.
Amen.
Refusing and be happy.
Amen.
Stressing out, pulling your hair out, getting frustrated, bent out of shape, mad for no reason, and all that good stuff.
Mm-hmm.
You can't be that way.
No. Nope.
God looking for that one that will go through hell and still come in smiling.
Yeah.
Amen.
Going through